this tutorial, we will do an exercise using Modbus Master. In a master-slave network, there is one and only one master and one or more slaves identified by an address, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. The slaves can be any current product, like parametric controller, like EVD driver, Power Plus, the input-output expansion board, CPCOE, as well as any programmable controller like CPICO, CPICO Mini and other PICO system controller, as well as any third parties devices communicating with this protocol. In the master side, the master can be again a PICO or CPICO controller, as well as any CAREL supervisory system like PlantWatch and PlantVisor, BOSS and so on, and again any third party supervisory system. Talking about PICO CPICO, when it is the slave, typically the master is a supervisory system, and vice versa, when the CPICO is the master, typically the slaves are field devices like EVD driver and Power Plus, as also shown in this slide. So in this case, CPICO is the master, and in the field bus line there is the CPICO E expansion board or the EVD or Power Plus. Well, and this is the current exercise. So far we have developed a software, an application communicating in Modbus Slave, and we will add another CPICO controller, CPICO CPICO mini controller, that will behave as the master into this master slave network. In this exercise we will have just one slave. We may have more than one, but we will have just one slave with a fixed address 1. The slave exchange these variables, the temperature, compressor, and status. So what can do the master? This is an exercise, so we can exchange just a couple of variables, like the temperature and the set point. Two variables are enough for this exercise, because read or write other variables of the same slave, as well as other variables of other slaves, is exactly the same. At this point, we have two options, as usual, regarding the implementation of this exercise. The first option is use the current application for the slave device, and then create a new project from scratch, or again from the project template, for the master. So the slave will have all these masks with menu mask, whatever else, also with its strategy, that okay, doesn't matter, while the master will have just one mask showing the two variables coming from the slave, and basically no strategy, because just to read these variables and show in a mask, the strategy is not necessary. We just need in CDesign a new line for the Modbus master. So first option, two independent, separated, specific projects for the slave and for the master. The second option is, it is a little bit faster to do, maybe a little bit more complicated to understand. That is, we can use just one project. So we can just add the variables where to save the values coming from the slave. We can create just one mask where to show these variables, and that's it. So we will use all these variables when we will use that software in the slave, while we will use the new mask with just these two variables when we will use that project, that application, in the master. This architecture, it is just one application for the logical master and logical slave, is very used in the standard application, for example like this, in the modular chiller, where there is just one project for the master and the slaves, so each controller manages a given number of compressors, and the first one that behaves as the master manages the system features like the temperature regulation, the unit alarms, and so on. So let's proceed with this structure. We can start creating two variables where to save the values coming from the slave. So a good name is the same name of the slave variables with a suffix underscore slave. So set point temperature slave is the variable used when the application runs as master, the variable where to save the set point coming from the slave. Okay, see strategy. No, this is the mask. I have already opened the project. We create a global variable. Rather than create a new variable from scratch here, I can just copy and paste. Here is a copy, paste. So all the properties are the same. I just rename the variable slave. Slave is okay, read write, actually should be only read only, also this one could be, should be also read only. Input output, not necessary because it is not connected to any physical input output. Protocol is good because we have to send via Modbus. User interface correct because we want to show in the mask. We can just rename here. The same for the other variable, the set point, copy, paste, also in this case I rename slave, read write is correct, retain, protocol UI, okay, all others are correct, just rename the variable slave. Okay, that's all regarding the strategy because we just need the variables, the master, there is no or any specific strategy for the master. Mask. The mask, here we have to create a mask where to show those two variables. I don't know what could be a good place, maybe a good place could be here in the info menu that is accessible through the quick menu info. So we could add here at the end a new mask, okay, new mask, okay, already connected, I can just rename slave info, we can place a text. I am the master. So it's clear that we will use this mask only when this software is used as the master. And then the description and the variables of the slave. So water inlet temperature slave. And set point slave, okay. The variables water in the temperature slave, and the same for the set point slave and also the other the slave. Well, that's all in the mask. Now we can start the interesting part that is here in C Design. The workflow to manage a master line is very similar to the one for a slave line. There is just one additional step, because here in the master we have to configure how many slaves there are and their corresponding addresses, 1234 or the IP address in case of Modbus TCP. So also now we start adding a new line, we select the protocol, Modbus master, the name, description doesn't matter, we have to bind the line to a port, Ethernet port for Modbus TCP in this case, or a serial line for Modbus RTU. So we will use this port because, like the other, has already an the serial card, RS-45 serial card. Like before, double click to configure the communication parameters, the speed, data bit, and so on. And then the next step is the new one, because now we don't have to select immediately the variables to read to write, but we have to select before how many slaves there are, the address, a number 123 or an IP. I told you that in this exercise we have just one slave, so we can delete this one. The address is 1. Before to configure this line, this slave, we can have a look to the line properties, that are properties that regards all the slaves devices of this line. Well, the user manual F1, the user manual contains a description of all the properties. So using CDesign, no editors, protocol editor. So here are the description of the properties. So the most interesting are this one. The detection interval is once a slave has been put offline, the master retry to communicate with it after 20 seconds. Also the last polling loop time is interesting. So the loop time is, the polling time is the time between the two enquiries of the same slave. Okay, that's enough for now, so go back to the network. We can give a name. Also in this case it's not so mandatory. And double click somewhere to configure that slave. Well, this part is very similar to the part in the slave. That is the place where we have to select the variables. Before to do this, another quick look to the others. Also in this case, the properties are described in the manual. Very interesting is this, the device error. More than an error is the device status. That is, the master can know the status of the slave. Status means like this. Device answered as expected, that is, the slave is online, no problem, is communicating, and so on. As well as device has not yet been queried, so that is the initial status. After this, becomes offline, online, and so on. So that was just a reminder of these properties. Okay, also others are interesting, but for this exercise, it's enough. Go back to the variables. Now we have to read the temperature. Here is to read the water inlet temperature. The water inlet temperature of the slave is sent through the input register number 1. So we have to read the input register 1 and write that value in the variable that we have created before, slave. So the value that comes from the input register 1 of the slave is saved into the variable water in the temperature slave. The other is read write, so it is the hold register 2. The variable is set point slave. Very important is the size. Size must be the same of the slave, let's say, of course. Well, there is just one additional property that we can see here on the right. Is access. There are a lot of options. What is the purpose of this this property? The point is that the slave role is quite easy because the slave has just to reply to the master's to the master inquires requests. So tell me what you need and I will reply with those information. While the role of the master is more let's say complex, because the master must implement the polling policy, that is when to inquire a given slave, when to inquire the slave 1, the slave 2, the slave 3, and for a given slave decide what data point read, the register, the coil, the input, or the others, and so on. So this properties is for this purpose. So the options are read poll, you see, basically there is no read, read poll, and read online. For write, there is no write, write change, and write online. There are not all the possible combinations, but the most used one. So for example, read poll, no write, means that every polling cycle, the polling is the sequence of inquire. So polling cycle means that the master inquires the first slave, and then the second, third, the fourth, and then restart with the first, the second, third, the fourth. So this is the polling cycle. So read poll means every time the master inquires that slave, it will read the variable. Write change means that the master will write the variable only when it changes in the master. We are talking about the master. So when the variable, for example, the set point slave changes, it will send the value to the slave once. So it is a write once. So read poll, no write, means read every poly cycle and never write. While read poll write change is what I just told you, it is read every problem cycle, every polling cycle, and write only when it changes. So for the temperature, read poll, no write sounds good because the temperature is, let's say, defined, read the slave, the master just read it, doesn't make sense to change. While for the set point, that we saw that is should be read-write, makes sense read poll, so the slave will read every polycycle and write only when it changes in the master. Other options are, for example, read poll write change like the previous one, and write online. That is, as soon as the master and the slave start the communication, the master write the value. So as soon as this and this start to the communication, the master writes once the value that is saved here. After that, like before, read every polling cycle and write only when change. Okay, and then there are other combinations. The point is, what is the right property for a given variable or given device? Depends. Because depends on the specific variable for a specific application. Well, the important for now is to know that there is this property that allows you to define the polling policy. So check again for the temperature, read pole, write, for set point, read pole, write change. Very good. That's all, so we can test, okay, save. Well, how to test a system like this? Let's say, as usual, there are two options. The first is use two controllers. We will load the same software in the two controllers. So in the first, we will connect the cable to the BMS2 port. So it will communicate through this port in Modbus slave. And on the other side, the field bus, so it will communicate in Modbus master. When we will be in front of this controller, we will use the masks for the slave, while when we will be in front of this controller, we will take care, we will see only the mask, the new mask that we have created before, that shows the variables coming from the slave. The second option, use just one controller and simply connect the BMS2 to the near field bus 2, so this one to this one. In this case, the controller will communicate with itself, but it doesn't know that it is communicating with itself. It is simply communicating in Modbus slave here and in Modbus master here, but it will work. And this is what we will do. Okay, first of all, I have to upload. Okay, this is the right one. Well, while it is uploading, I connect the two ports, use the cable. And I'm connecting the controller in this way. Well, start unit on. We have to enable all compressors. Set point. By the way, later in the next exercise, we'll talk about the fault values, initializations, and so on. So, 4 degrees. Well, so now we are looking, let's say, the mask of the slave. So, the slave is reading 11.36. What is reading the master? So we placed the mask for the slave here in the info menu at the end. So it is the water temperature of the slave is 11.4, so it works. Now I'm changing the temperature in the slave, and in fact here the master. Is reading the right value. Set point. Okay, this is the master, and now I will change the set point in the master. Remember that for the set point I have selected for the set point in the master track change. So as soon as I confirm, it detects the change, so it will send the variable to the slave, and here is in the slave the set point 5.5. Very well, so the master and slave communicate each other. Another way to test the Modbus master is connect the controller to a PC where runs a tool that is able to simulate or communicate in Modbus slave, like ModSim. Also in this case, it is not a current tool. But I believe that what we've done is more effective to test the communication. Well, a quick review. So to manage Modbus master, but I repeat, for the curl master and also the BACnet client, more or less is the same. So we have, first of all, as we have already seen, create a line master, enter, and then we have to select the slaves that exist in the line. In the line properties, okay, it's self-explaining the properties of the line. After that, it is also, by the way, it's also possible to add import as template. That is, rather than add one by one the, let's say, the 100 variables of a slave, it is possible to create a template that is a list of variables, a list of data points with their name, data type, register, coil, address, and so on, and reuse it. Well, we will do an exercise like this, using this feature, in the tutorial number 30, the one regarding the device libraries. Okay, the important for now, as usual, is to know that it is possible to import-export variables, also like in this case. Next, double-click, you enter in the configuration of a given slave. So in the variables, like in the slave, you select the data point. In the network setting, properties of a specific slave, like the device error I mentioned before, and also the register coil number. This is the solution of the exercise. So this is the slave exercise of the slave. In the master, we have simply added just one slave, address one, just a couple of variables, reading the input register 1 and 2, the two variables, and then define the read-write mode, and that's it. There is just one information here, that is attention when you connect two controllers, because not all serial ports of all models of all controllers are opto-insulated, so that if you connect two controllers that are supplied by different sources, there is the risk of a short circuit. So, as this sentence states, refer to the CPIC manual when we have to connect together different controllers. Last point, other protocols. Because so far we talk about CARL and Modbus, also BACnet, master and slave. What about other protocols, for example in LON or KNX? In this case we have to use additional serial cards to be plugged in these ports to support this protocol. In this case there are some further programming steps. For example, for the LON we have to configure the LON card using the LON set. We have also to work with the unit of measure that we will see in another tutorial. Something very similar is also for CONEX, for this protocol. Also in this case we have to configure the card using the key set. Maybe you are wondering why to use the PIC web communicating in HTTP when there is a web server inside the controller. Could make sense because with PIC web it is possible to send email, so you may use PIC web not for the internal web server, its internal web server, but to send email. Another reason is for example BACnet. Why use PICONET for BACnet when BACnet is supported natively by the controller? For example, in order to have two BACnet lines. In fact, as stated here, there is just one instance of BACnet. So I can use BACnet whenever I want, but just once. It is a client-server, but just once. So I can't use BACnet MSTP here and BACnet TCP. So using the PicoNet or also the PicoWeb, I can have two instances, two lines using BACnet. Well, this is really all also for this tutorial. Thank you for watching.